Good morning.
You want the stool?
No, this is fine.
Can it catch your voice back here?
No.
I think so, you know, somewhere. No more you back here.
No, like,
I heard unless that was him. Yeah, can hear us. I can hear us somewhere. Yeah, I hear us talking. You need that built in?
No, just see.
Oh, it's not catching. Is it not powering? Where's the sun? This thing not powering up.
The USB.
Straight into it, but it's not powering up.
You know what? That might not have enough juice. You got
to do 95.
No, no.
Or just go.
You still always draw power. Or draw power from there.
Yeah. You want a power cord?
Give you another laptop. Just power up separately.
Okay. Good electric phone. The power up. I'll grab my
dog. I have a power bank.
This thing not powering up.
Just the this light. Stream?
Yeah, that whole thing not powering up for some reason, oddly. So we're just gonna get separate power grid.
Yeah.
I got this, so let's see.
What does this allow us to do? This box?
This? Yeah. To get the audio out. Luckily I went this and we're like, it's me and Casey talking back here.
Still not powering up.
Still not powering.
So it's that thing that's
not. Shouldn't be, we just used it. Mayfair.
Oh, cable.
Oh, cable.
The simplest thing
for us. Yeah, this
is not one. Put it right side. Power.
Case. You cycled it to itself.
Hi, good morning again. No. We're going to get started in just a second. They're working out a small technical difficulty with the live stream, and then we're going to get started. So they needed me to actually just talk on the mic, so I'm just letting you know we're going to get started in a second so they can test it out in the back. Be back with you in hopefully less than a minute. Thanks.
Good morning, parents, guests, teachers, and students. My name is Amy Higa. Welcome to Noelani School's fifth grade graduation. We are all so excited to share this moment with all of you. Thank you.
like it somehow. I guess I thought that this would never end. And suddenly it's like the women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us round? Will this memories fade when I leave this town? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. I keep on thinking it's a time to fly.
Everyone, my name is Kanan. We would like to take this time to thank the second grade teachers and our buddies for making the graduation lays.
We'd also like to give a round of applause to recognize all the teachers and staff at Noelani for their hard work and support throughout our years here.
Without the encouragement from our parents, grandparents, aunties, uncles, and other family members, we wouldn't be standing here today. Thank you very much.
You know, the thought that comes to mind is, this has been a fun year. I've seen the return of smiles and laughter and fist bumps. You know, we had a craft fair and a trunk or treat. We returned to the Big Island two times to make up for lost opportunities. We ended the year with an awesome May Day performance and a fair after. If we say a positive word about the COVID-19 pandemic, it's that we're grateful for the opportunities we may not have appreciated so much in the past. So as I do every year, I like to offer our graduates advice as you move forward in your journey. So first, stretch yourself. As you move through life's journey, it's important to continue to experience new things. I challenge you to try something new every month. And if you stick to the plan, by the time you graduate high school, you would have experienced over 80 things you wouldn't have otherwise. Next, today's celebration is about you, but it's not gonna always be about you. We try to instill courage, gratitude, forgiveness, and compassion in you. As you know, we have a monthly award called the Kind Kid of the Month. I encourage you to believe that you are working towards earning that Kind Kid of the day, the week, the month, or even the year in the future as your own personal challenge. The impact that you have on people will be tremendous, and believe me, it'll return to you tenfold. Lastly, I talk about this every year, so I'd like you to listen up and look at me. Choose your friends wisely. You're gonna meet a lot of new and interesting people in the coming years. Those you call your friends will be the people who build you up. A friend is someone who understands your past, believes in your future, and accepts you just the way that you are. Everyone else is just an acquaintance. These are the people who you are friendly with, but will come and go in your life. So be cautious on who you call a friend. So fifth graders, enjoy the day. Celebrate with your family and friends. Congratulations, Gecko Class of 2023. Once a gecko, always a gecko.
Thank you, Mr. Gossman. We'll be sure to remember what you said.
Three of our graduating fifth graders, Zora Maurer, Nico Uishi, Noah Yamamoto Weibel, will share a little something about their memories and experiences here at Noelani.
Colorful A8 classroom squealed as they heard their teacher, Mishigaki, telling them that Mrs. Gonzalez's rabbit was going to be brought to school that day. I don't know why this news excited only some people, leaving the rest of the class unaffected, but I swear, a few of the students actually had sparkles in their eyes. Yeah, Mishigaki shot back, her voice enthusiastic as always. You want to go visit it? That was Mishigaki, constantly trying to make our fifth grade year as good as it could possibly be. A small number of kids, three or four, including myself, poured hurriedly out of the classroom, frolicking to A12. I enjoyed that short walk. I fancied taking in my surroundings in as many situations as possible. It was a brisk morning. The gray clouds were slowly swirling in the wind. Everyone was tired from the school year and short weekend. But, as I like to say, no better way to regain energy than to visit a bunny on a random day's morning. Quickly, the fifth graders reached their destination and stayed in a clump in front of the closed door. I'd forgotten that, in A12, you had to wait outside of the class until 8 o'clock. It was around 7:45. It was going to be a long morning. While I waited, I took in the fourth graders. I'd always thought they were cooler than the fifth graders, but maybe it's because I didn't know them very well. The so-called line they were standing in was infuriatingly swirly. I glanced at Chloe Yu and Christopher Nagata, two of my friends, an anxious look on my face, seeing if they understood my frustration. Chloe looked at me and tilted her head, flaunting a face that was clearly meant to tell me not to do anything. My insides twisted instinctively as I thought about how all of fifth grade was going to be divided by the next year. It was becoming a common unwanted feeling. Anyway, I, being the crazy annoying, headstrong person that I am, I ignored my friend's warning. Hey, y'all, I called out to the line of fourth graders. This is not a line. Can we please try to stay against the wall right here? I didn't mean to be rude. I immediately regretted my words and actions. Do other kids think like this? I didn't know the answer to my own question. Moments later, a single footstep was heard before a figure emerged at the top of the stairwell. There, holding a small black metal cage in hand, was Mrs. Gonzalez in one of her usual stylish, colorful outfits. Students of the fourth and fifth grade piled into the room swiftly. As Mrs. Gonzalez opened the cage and set a small, cute rabbit into a pet bed, she told the fourth graders to move out of our way. After all, the fifth graders were the big dogs on campus. Flashbacks hit me like a pie to the face. Days, weeks, months of walking into that classroom. It smelled the same. It looked different. The other, newer kids knew exactly where everything in the room was. Of course, they were the new inhabitants of the classroom. Chloe, Chris, Kira, and a few other fifth graders walked to the couch. I slid to the floor, not moving my eyes away from the rabbit. Its big, beady black eyes stared blankly at all of us as we intently watched it move and hop around. I quickly turned my head to Kira, who was kneeling next to me. We exchanged awes to honor the bunny's cuteness. Moments passed. I found myself cluelessly wandering around the room. I pointed out to Kira and Chloe that the fourth grade desks and chairs were smaller than the ones in fifth grade. Various emotions toyed with my insides as I realized that I had not noticed a difference in chair size at the beginning of fifth grade. It was yet another reminder that that everyone had simultaneously changed throughout the years. Eventually, we hopped back to A8 and started the school day. Some may say it's an empty, never-ending loop. Every year, the fifth graders leave Noelani. Then the fourth graders become the fifth graders and get prepared to leave. Then they do leave. Though it may be a loop, it's inevitable. Every year is different, for every grade, class, and student is different. And though the fifth graders will soon leave Noelani and be separated from each other, I'm sure that every student will use their differences to find different ways to fit in. New schools bring new memories and experiences. This is what I learned after taking one look backward and two hops forward. Thank you.
When I look back at my years at Noelani, it's hard to remember what things were like before COVID. When we finally returned to school in person, I enjoyed all the things I took for granted before COVID. Things like talking about what you did over the weekend and eating lunch with the class. Because of COVID, we didn't get to go on all the different field trips we were supposed to. So when we went back in person in fourth grade, I was really excited to go on the Big Island trip. Everybody said the trip was really awesome and fun. After my big brother came back from the trip with my dad, I couldn't wait to become a fourth grader and go on that trip. When I found out that we weren't going in fourth grade, I was extremely disappointed because I had waited for so long. In fifth grade, Things got more like they were pre-COVID, and I hoped that we would go on the Big Island trip. We kept waiting to see if we were going, and finally, the school decided that we were going to go. I couldn't wait to go to the Big Island. When the big day finally came, I remember waking up at the crack of dawn and sitting with my mom in my dad's truck on the drive to the airport. I felt so excited to get on the plane and fly to the Big Island. Even though I woke up at 3 a.m., I was more awake than on any other school day. I had waited for so long to go on the Big Island trip, and my dream was finally coming true. Once we sat down at the gate, my mom, Ellerina, her mom, and I ate our breakfast. I felt the crunchiness of the bread in my mouth as I enjoyed my ham and cheese croissant. Once Ellerina and I finished eating, we roamed around the gate and looked at what everybody was doing. The boys were playing cards, and some girls were just chatting about how excited they were. We walked over to our friends and sat down. We all sat in a circle facing inward at each other and started playing Put a Finger Down. I looked around and saw everyone smiling and having fun. It would seem like this moment wasn't anything special, but to me, it was. It was a surreal moment. I wasn't being told what to do, I wasn't taking a test, and I wasn't working on an assignment. I was feeling the moment, having fun, going to the Big Island and with my friends. Having a simple moment like that with my friends was really special because I couldn't do that during COVID. Now that I'm graduating, I recall a lot of different memories from Noelani. But what I will remember most are the special moments I spent with my friends. As we graduate and start our new journeys, I hope you remember your special moments too.
It was 7 o'clock at night. I had remembered Mr. F's voice echoing through the bus. Get to bed early, we have a busy day ahead of us. But me, Quinn, and Shane wanted nothing to do with it. We had just taken our showers and were about to go to bed when Quinn pulled out a deck of cards with an exasperated look on his face. Let's play war, he breathed. I could hear my dad groaning in the background. As Quinn was handing out the cards, I peered out of our hotel window at all of the gleaming buildings of the Big Island. I could see the stars and rising moon contrasting the now dark purple night sky. Man, it's getting late, I thought before turning back to my card game. Quinn went first and slapped a king hard on the wood floor. For the next couple of minutes, it was a competition of who could slap a card down the hardest. We were laughing and yelling the whole time, keeping my dad awake. I felt really bad for the people in the room next to us. My friend Shane quickly ran out of cards, and it was just me and Quinn now. I promptly flipped down the top card of my deck, sending pulses through the hardwood floor. We both put down aces. For a second, we were silent, but the very next moment, we were laughing and throwing pillows at each other while we played. After this, my dad kept reminding us that we should go to bed, but we were having so much fun that we just kept telling him one more game. We had finished our last game, my dad had fallen asleep, and I felt glad I had such good friends. This may seem like an insignificant, random moment during my time at Noelani, but I believe it wasn't. This is an example of the pure joy of spending wholesome time with your friends.
I'd like to introduce two of our fifth grade parents, Jason Uno's mother, Mrs. Kat Uno, and Nico Oishi's mother, Mrs. Kiriko Oishi, who will present our legacy gift.
We will present these leis to the parents.
Good morning. As you know, each year the graduating class leaves behind for the students who come after them and for the teachers and staff that have supported them over the years a legacy gift intended to remain a part of the school for many years to come. This year, the graduating class of 2023's gift is intended to brighten up the Idea Center, which they were so fortunate to have been one of the first classes to use. The Idea Center was completed during COVID and now houses Noelani's new library. In the back of the library, there's an area like the one in the original library where bookshelves line the walls, and in the middle, there's a carpeted area where students can read books. If you've been inside, it's really beautiful with high ceilings and natural sunlight. It's beautiful as it is, but the walls are still a little bare. So the legacy gift from the class of 2023 is artwork inspired by the class of 2023 of what Noelani is to them. I would like to now introduce Ms. Kat Uno. Kat is a children's illustrator. She's also a Noelani mom to Jason Uno in Ms. Shigaki's class. You can see many of her illustrations in children's books. She was the one who incorporated their ideas into artwork and brought them to life by designing the artwork. And without further ado, we'd like to present to you the artwork for the class of 2023 Legacy Gift. So this, yeah, okay.
So what the kids did is that they all provided just ideas of what Noelani School means to them, and I went through all of the kids' ideas and I kind of filtered out, you know, some of the things that I wanted to incorporate into the artwork. It's digitally done. It's just a rough draft, so we're still working on it. But I wanted to incorporate the rainbow, Mano Valley, and within the rainbow, there's all of these little things that the kids kind of, it was like common themes running through all of their ideas. So there's like the JPO kids, there's like backpacks and butterflies and music and a lot of things. And I also incorporated the Noelani song, the alma mater, because it seems like a few kids really felt that that was an important part of their school experience. So. Okay.
So. As you can see, it's still in concept right now, but the plan is to have this printed onto these three separate panels, and then we hope that next, so we'll put it up, we'll mount it in the library like this, and we hope that next time you come back to visit Noelani, you'll have a chance to visit the library and see your legacy gift there.
And I forgot to mention that each panel is dedicated to each class. So each class has all the kids' names based on the different classes.
So this one is Mr. Sakamoto. Shoot, I forgot to give you your light. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Oishi, for organizing our Legacy Gift project, and for Mrs. Kat Uno, whose creative eye helped transform plain boards into a mural we can be proud of.
We will now show you a video with highlights from our fifth grade year. Family and friends, please sit back and enjoy the show. Fifth graders, please arrange yourselves to view the video.
Good, 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 good weave it in and out. This is what life's all about. Yeah, breathe it in and out. This is what it's all about. These are the moments we live in.
Around my finger and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, it could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you, won't let no one break your heart. No, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. Never grow up.
It's the thought of being young when your heart stays like a drum, beating louder with nowhere to guard it. When it all seems like it's wrong, sing along to Elton John, and to that feeling we're just getting started.
When the nights get colder, rhythm's got you falling behind. Just dream about that moment when you look yourself right in the eye. Going, nothing I can stop how we move. Hey, let's make a we'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye. But yesterday's gone, we gotta keep moving on. I'm so thankful for the moment, so glad I got to know you. The times that we had, I'll keep like a photograph and hold you in my heart forever.
Mr. Higa. Fifth graders, please return to the stage and prepare to sing our graduation song, Count on Me. We will now have, thank you, fifth graders. We will now have the presentation of the diplomas by Mr. Gussman and the fifth grade teachers.
Doing in time here at Noelani School. As each of the students receive their diplomas, we will read one of their responses. There will be plenty of picture opportunities after this, so we kindly ask that you stay seated at this time. Zora Maurer, in 20 years, I want to live in a small gray house in the middle of a dark, rainy forest, writing horror stories in my big, fluffy loft bed. I will frolic down my stairwell to be alone in my dungeon, breaking the silence of the night with my loud vintage typewriter. James Zhang, in 20 years, I will be a mechanical engineer. I will live in a two-story penthouse in Florida with two kids, and I will be married. I will innovate and create a product for language translation, which will be cheap and easy to use.
Kale Maileali'i Misipeka. My favorite Noelani memory is when me and my friends had lunch bunch in the classroom because we got to play and sing along to our favorite songs. Shane Kanai. In 20 years, I see myself playing baseball in the MLB with plenty of money, but zero kids. I will be single and will live in a huge mansion with a swimming pool and a private batting cage. Agnea Padel. In 20 years, I see myself as a Rhode Island School of Design graduate in an air-conditioned fashion studio listening to my music and sketching clothes in my sketchbook. I'll have a medium-sized house with a small garden, and I might even have a partner, but I'm not sure.
Ashley Kusuda, my favorite memory is when we had the Manoa Marketplace field trip. We got to spend money on the things we want at the places we want. The memory was a sweet moment like eating a mochi donut. Nada El Sheikh, a life lesson that I learned as a Noelani student is don't go where the path may lead, instead go where there is no path and leave a trail. I learned this because once we were asked a question and only one person got it correct because everyone was just copying other people.
Abigail Jung, in 20 years I'll be a famous family doctor that is super wealthy and I'll live in New York and Korea. Switching every once in a while, I'll be loved with my friends and family and live close to my parents. I'll have two ragdoll cats named Cookie and Cream.
Layla Meredith, in 20 years, I will become a world-famous actor and singer. I will have a big two-story house with a Rottweiler named Thor, a husky named Luna, and a German shepherd named Nala. I will have a husband and twins, one boy and one girl, that can play with the doggies.
Mason Grant, in 20 years, I want to be an actor or a doctor. The reason why I want to be an actor is because I'm good at acting and I want to be rich and famous.
Jack Bell, in 20 years, I will own the house that I am currently living in. I will be a baker and 31 years old, and I hope to own at least a semi-popular bakery. Cade Kawachika, my favorite Noelani memory is when I sang famous songs from the 2000s and under to try and stump my teacher. Some bands included Nirvana, Vanilla Ice, Criss Cross, Spice Girls, and so on. He knew every single one.
Raiden X Storm Nakoa, in 20 years, I will be a famous football player. I will live in a mansion with two kids, both boys, and I will be married. I will also be driving a black Mercedes.
Hina Koa, my favorite Noelani memory is having fun with my friends and playing with them during recess, lunch, and before school. Tai Morikone, in 20 years, I'll be a Major League Baseball player, playing for the Atlanta Braves. I'll have a wife and two children. After my career, I'll move back to Hawaii to have a stable life. I'll have one oxalotl named Gary.
Justin Lum, my favorite Noelani memory was on Big Island at the Astronomy Center when I used the hammer to smash the copper cloth. We were so loud and it was so fun.
Miles Swan, in 20 years I'll have a small self-sustaining business, so I will not have to work. I will be retired. I will have a log cabin near the lower border of Wyoming with one dog. Bogus Wixana, I have fun on the Big Island trip with my dad. I felt happy at the Big Island trip eating ice cream, and I went to Kilauea and saw the steamy caldera.
Amy Higa, at Noelani, I've learned a lot. However, the most important thing that I learned is that procrastination gets you nowhere, so you should just do the work. It saves you a lot of stress.
Kanan Oyasato, in 20 years, I'll be a baseball player playing for the Yankees, earning millions with one son and one daughter.
Quinn Kumabe, at Noelani, I learned that people change. There was one time where I thought someone wasn't nice, but I ended up being friends with them when we got to know each other better. I learned not to judge people because a new year is a fresh start.
Chloe Marie Choi, in 20 years, I'll be a famous author known for my fantasy books, working inside a big spacious office, writing on the computer for upcoming stories.
Business making dog treats.
Susana Aruchunian, my favorite Noelani memory was when we were training for the track meet. I was listening to my music and on the grass watching to see if my friend won her race. Haruka Lux, a valuable life lesson that I learned was that nothing comes easily. Whether it's making friends, getting good grades, or even making money, no matter what, the only way to get these things is to earn it.
Sola Bang, in 10 years, I will be a successful manga artist. I will still be living with my mom and dad because I don't want them to be lonely.
Adrian Kim, my favorite Noelani memory at Noelani is when me and my group ordered brownies and vanilla ice cream at Big Island. This gives me memories sharing delicious food with my friends.
Braden Koyanagi, a life lesson that I learned from Noelani was to never procrastinate, because when you have a big project that is due, it is not fun staying up all night doing it.
Kyrie Viella, in 20 years, I'll be the owner of at least 20 dogs, 10 American bullies, and 10 Pomeranians, and 2 parrots. I want to live in a huge house that has maids, chefs, and big beds for guests, and big closets in each room.
Ooh. Emma Pastori Braden, one life lesson I learned. Don't be shy, and don't think everyone around you is better than you. I learned that everyone is different in their own good way.
Sherry Lee, one of my favorite memories at Noelani Elementary School was a Big Island trip. When we went to Akaka Falls and saw the waterfall, which is really nice to see.
Jean Chang, I learned that no matter where you are, there is a spot for you. I was a new student 8 months ago, but now I am a person that fits in with the Noelani community. A lot of my friends were helpful to me, and I wish that is the case in the future. Avery Miyamoto, in 20 years, I will have an engineering job at NASA. I will live in New York, and I will live in a medium-sized mansion. Lastly, I will be rich, giving money to the poor.
Kewid Fiti, in 20 years, I will be a chef working at a popular restaurant, hoping to earn lots of money, and one day open the most popular restaurant in the country. I will have a wife and 2 kids, a boy and a girl, with a husky and a house next to a basketball court.
Jason Uno, I learned that making friends is the most important thing, and that they always have your back no matter what. They will stay with you to the end and will always be there for you when you are sad or having a bad day. Friends will cheer you up and help you out. Chen Kai Chu, in 20 years, I'll have a silver Maybach working with the Los Angeles Lakers. Chloe Yu, some life lessons I've learned was to never be afraid to try something new. For example, I tried so many different new things I would have never tried before, such as Variety Show, Speech Fest, and JPO. I also learned to salvage every moment because time flies. You only live once, and it felt like just yesterday I was in kindergarten.
Manny Nua, in 20 years from now, I'll be playing football for the Steelers because football is fun for me.
Mahalo's Nuokas, in 20 years, I'll work for HPD in the K-9 unit. I will have a wife with 2 kids and a German Shepherd. I will have my own Mercedes G-Wagon.
Leilani Suyat, my favorite Noelani memory was the Manoa stream field trip. We had to walk in the stream to get rid of invasive fish. I was excited and happy walking in the stream, making lots of noise, and hanging out with my classmates.
Ellerina Trewick, in 20 years, I'll be a full-time pediatrician working in New York City with 3 cats, a husband, a million-dollar house with 3 children, 2 girls, and 1 boy.
Lily Motosue, my life lesson I learned is that time flies by very quickly. I first started in kindergarten, and now I'm in 5th grade. It's just hard to believe that I was once a young and cute girl, and now I'm getting older by the day. Next thing we know, we will all be old and gray.
Christopher Nagata, in 20 years, I'll be a professional NBA player and travel the world with my friends in my private yacht. I will have 2 kids, 1 boy and 1 girl, and I will be married. I will provide food for my family. I will have a mansion by the beach.
Reese Somoso, in 20 years, I'll be living in Switzerland, living in a penthouse, 3 dogs and 2 children, 1 boy and 1 girl, and I'll be a model for Vogue, helping people in need. Kyoko Masuda, in 20 years, I think I'll be in Italy with my dream job, heart surgeon with my sheepdog named Pochi. Noah Andrade, in 20 years, I see myself playing in the NBA and playing on the Boston Celtics. I'll make millions of dollars a season. I'll live in a 2-story house with 2 dogs and no kids. I will not be getting married.
Noah Yamamoto Weibel, in 20 years, I will live in a big house with a wife, 2 kids, and a fluffy pet beagle. I will be a biology professor working for UH. For my PhD, I will write a science fiction novel about the Earth in 1,000 years.
Carson Luo, in 20 years, I'm going to be a pilot with 1 kid, a wife, a bull terrier dog, 40 chickens, and live in a big penthouse in Japan.
Tristan Fragus, in 20 years, I want to have a big house with a wife and 2 kids, a girl and a boy, and a pet dog. I will become a famous YouTuber and be able to get a huge mansion when I get rich.
Colton Murata, one important lesson I learned this year is to enjoy every moment with your friends before you say goodbye.
Cameron Hidani, in 20 years, I'll own a big house. I'll also own 2 Shiba Inus and drive a nice Tesla car. Lastly, I will take care of my parents and siblings.
Caitlin Tokuda, in 20 years, I will have a bachelor's degree and become a YouTuber, artist, and gamer. I'll have a big house with plenty of cute cats, and my kids are my cats. They are all my favorite children.
Kira Landgraf. In 20 years, I will make a lot of money to get a big house and be a successful artist. I will have 7 cats who will make me happy. I will also have my parents visit me all the time.
Sarah Nakasone. One lesson that I've learned is to work together with others and be open to what they have to say. By doing this, I will have a chance to learn and improve by listening to others' input and perspective.
Chrissy Tamaye. In 20 years, I'll be a teacher in New York City with 2 Pomeranians and 2 kids.
Kaya Chang. My favorite memory was our last ever Mayfair. My friend threw water balloons at Mr. Higa and we all got into a big water fight. I was soaking wet from head to toe in my Mayfair dress. Mr. Higa thought he wouldn't get soaked at that Mayfair, but we changed his fate.
Nika Oishi. In 20 years, I'll be a full-time pediatric dentist living in LA, and I will not have any children yet. I will have my own dance studio and will own 3 cats named Lily Koi, Lychee, and Guava. I'll live in a 3-story house and will invite my parents to live with me.
Dean Araki, in 20 years, I will be 31 and have a job, maybe even a house that I rent out and live in the basement of. I will probably be broke and have a bike instead of a car because it's cheap. Also, I will hope that in 20 years, I am taller than 4'5½".
Teachers, students, and families, I would like to present to you the 60th graduating class of Noelani School, the class of 2023.
Before we end, we would like to thank Mr. Richard for helping set up the cafeteria, Ms. Aya for printing our diplomas, and all the other support staff for helping us with the preparations for our graduation program. We would also like to thank the many parents who volunteered their time or items for the Grade 5 banquet, graduation, and legacy gift. We also want to thank the parents who accompanied us to the Big Island and other field trips, and to all the parents who donated items to our school throughout the years. You have made Noelani School the special place that it is.
We wish the graduating class of 2023 much success at their new schools. And remember, once a gecko,
always a gecko.
This concludes our 2023 Noelani graduation program. After the lower grades leave, parents and friends can stay to take pictures. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Amy and Kanan. Great.